Leia here from leiafirstsight.com/MCAT, and in this video, I will show you how to find RNS when you're dealing with a Fischer projection. You can find my entire series on Fischer projections along with my practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website leiafirstsight.com/Fischer. Now, this video is not an in-depth chirality review, but specifically looking at Fischer projection. So if you're not comfortable with how to find RNS, make sure you review that first and then come back to this video. In video one, we looked at how to read a Fischer projection and introduced Mr. Organic Chemistry, which helps you remember that the bow tie or the horizontal lines represent groups coming out of the page and the vertical lines represent the vertebrae going back and into the page. You also have to be comfortable ranking your atoms for priority to find RNS. And while there are over 100 atoms on the periodic table, when it comes to chirality, I highly recommend memorizing these 10 atoms. These are the 10 atoms you'll see over and over in your organic chemistry course, and it helps you remember trends, such as electronegativity going up to the right, but more importantly for this, size, which goes down to the left. We're going to rank the atoms in order of highest atomic number, and that's the specific atom attached to the chiral carbon, and then decreasing. So iodine will always be your highest, then bromine, then chlorine, sulfur, phosphorus, then fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, and finally hydrogen will always be your lowest priority. So looking at this Fischer projection, the first thing we want to do is rank our groups. When you see hydrogen, that's always number 4. Looking at the other atoms, we have bromine as number 1, oxygen number 2, and carbon as number 3. We only care about the top 3 priorities as long as number 4 is into the page or on a Fischer projection, up or down. Cancel out number 4, trace the path from 1 to 2 to 3, and since the top of the path goes to the right, that is R. But what happens when your lowest priority isn't going into the page? Let's take a look at the Fischer projection for L-serine. The first thing we want to do is rank the atoms in order of priority. We recognize nitrogen to be number 1, hydrogen to be number 4, but then we're faced with a carbon and a carbon, so what do we do? I'm going to break it out to show you, but this is something you need to get comfortable doing in your head. The first group we're looking at is a carbon double bound to an oxygen, which you want to envision as 2 bonds to oxygen. So I drew out 2 oxygens and then another oxygen. And we're comparing that to a carbon bound to 2 hydrogen atoms and then an OH. We start by comparing the carbons. They're exactly the same, so we cancel that out. Then we look at the next highest priority on that carbon atom. For the carboxylate, I can choose any of the 3 oxygen atoms to compare to this oxygen. Once again, they're exactly the same and cancel out. So we go back to the carbon atom and look for the next highest priority. For the carboxylate, we have an oxygen, but for the alcohol, we have just a hydrogen. Since oxygen beats hydrogen, carboxylate is going to be priority number 2, and the alcohol will be priority number 3. Now we cross out number 4 and trace the path from 1 to 2 to 3, which looks like it should be R. But the problem is we're not looking at this correctly because number 4 has to be in the back and here it's in the front. You can do different things here like swap, rotate, or redraw the molecule. But if priority number 4 is directly in the front, just pretend you're looking at this backwards. So if looking at it from the front gives me a clockwise or R turn, looking at it from the back will be exactly the opposite, which means I have a counterclockwise or S configuration. L-serine is in the S configuration. What if you're given an example that has a Fischer projection with 2 chiral carbons? You treat it the same way by looking at 1 chiral carbon at a time and finding that chirality. So we'll pick the first chiral carbon and rank the groups in order of priority. Here's the quick guide so that you can follow along. Bromine is priority number 1. Hydrogen is priority number 4. Methyl is 3. That makes this entire group on the bottom 2. How did I get that so quickly? Whenever you see a hydrogen, it's always, always going to be your absolute lowest priority. Make that number 4. Whenever you see a methyl, it is always going to be your second lowest priority if a hydrogen is present. But if there's no hydrogen present, it will always be your absolute lowest priority, assuming you have no deuterium, which you may see. So I didn't even have to look at anything else because hydrogen is the lowest. Methyl is the second lowest atom because it has a carbon bound to the lowest atom, hydrogen, and so I automatically knew that was number 3. But let's say I didn't know that. What I would have to do is compare what I see. I have a carbon, and that right there is another carbon. They are the same, so we have to look at the next highest priority on that atom. For the methyl group, we have hydrogen, but for the lower group, we have an oxygen. Since oxygen beats hydrogen, the lower portion of the Fischer projection outranks the methyl group, which is why the lower portion is 2 and the methyl group is 3. Now that we have our priority, cancel out number 4, trace the path from 1 to 2 to 3. It looks like it should be R, but because hydrogen is coming out of the page, remember the bow tie on Mr. Organic Chemistry, it's coming forward, so you have to reverse it. Look at it from the back, and that gives you S. Let's do the same thing for the lower carbon. Alcohol is my highest priority, that's 1. Hydrogen is always number 4. Methyl is always behind hydrogen, number 3. So once again, the rest of the Fischer projection is number 2. But if you didn't know that, just compare carbon to carbon. They cancel each other out. The next highest priority on the methyl is a hydrogen. The next highest priority in that upper group is a bromine. And since bromine outranks hydrogen, the upper group is 2 and methyl is 3. And so we cancel out number 4. Trace the path from 1 to 2 to 3, which looks like it should be R, but because hydrogen is coming forward, we have to reverse it. Look at it from the other side, and that means once again we're dealing with S. But what if you're still not comfortable with this structure and want to draw your Fischer as a sawhorse? Or what if you're given a sawhorse projection, meaning a 3-dimensional molecule, and you're asked to convert that to a Fischer projection? That's exactly what I'll be covering in the next video, which you can catch along with my Fischer projections cheat sheet and practice quiz by visiting my website, leahforsci.com/Fischer.